In the world of sport, legends surface only once in a single generation. At the 2018 Olympic Winter Games in South Korea, a new legend is on the cusp of emerging as one freestyle athlete attempts to make history. But to reach that moment, and what the cheering crowds don't see, requires dedication, sacrifice, failure, and ultimately, passion. Despite the increasing specialization in freestyle snowboard disciplines, the addition of snowboard big air into the 2018 Olympic Winter Games lets us dream about the birth of legends like Usain Bolt, Carl Lewis, and Michael Phelps. For the first time, a single freestyle athlete could feasibly walk away with three medals across slopestyle, halfpipe, and big air. Do you think it's possible for a single athlete to win?
Yeah, there's...
With 159 days until South
Jack, quand on en arrive.
At this point, neither he nor the coaches know what the final design of the slopestyle park being constructed in Pyeongchang will look like. So his goal at the national training camp is to utilize the park's features to practice the tricks he plans to use during the competitive season, while also beginning to think about the run he wants to unveil in South Korea. Each one of these athletes considers it an honor and a privilege to be selected to train at the national training camp in Japan, even though many are aware they won't make the final shortlist for the 2018 Olympic Winter Games. At the first major big air event of the 2016 season in Japan, there is a huge amount of excitement and pressure in the air after the International Olympic Committee announced during the summer of 2015 that the discipline would be included for the first time at the 2018 Olympic Winter Games. With big air now thrust into the world spotlight, talk begins of which athletes will be the ones to journey to Pyeongchang.
Couldn't get the landing gear down. The judges are gonna dock some big points for that. Shout, did that just happen? Yes, it did. And nobody here was expecting a debut run like that. I mean, what a start to the season.
Thank you.
plenty of air coming out of that jump, but will it be used? Oh, taking some huge risk here with those massive tricks, but every one of them is paying off big dividends. So far, we have seen huge, huge performances in the first two events from him here in Japan. So what I want to know is, can he make it 3 for 3 today?
That was awesome!
Yes, another engaging run for sure, but I really wonder if he's happy with his performance today.
While the pressure of competing is all...
You can really feel the tension amongst the athletes after that quad backflip landing earlier today. Like, how do you follow that? I don't think you can, but if he wants to, he's gonna have to dig deep into his bag of tricks. Look at that! Have you ever seen a run like this? So unlucky. Hopefully that won't hurt the score too much at the end.
Oh, yeah!
And into the front flip, smooth, with a very smooth landing. Oh, taking some huge risk here with those massive tricks, but every one of them is paying off big dividends.
Woo! What a
run. He gave it one heck of a shot and turned in a super impressive start. What a kickoff to the season with that quad backflip and our first glimpse of possible contender.
しっかりこういう風にやってオリンピック。
By the end of the tour, the long journey towards the 2018 Olympic Winter Games has begun. But in between the rigorous training, athletes know that sometimes a break is needed. Which is why he decides to venture to Japanese backcountry to explore the landscape on offer.Escapism in beautiful Japanese backcountry, the harsh reality of what lies ahead rears its head once again. Preparation and training for the 2018 Games. While slopestyle competitions have played a major role in snowboarding, both before and after its inclusion in the 2014 Olympic Winter Games in Sochi, it became clear that events were becoming tiresome when style began to take a backseat in favor of a spin-to-win mentality. For South Korea, design has been brought back to the fore. For many of the athletes, The course in Phoenix Snow Park promises to be one of the most creative in any slopestyle event to date. And 2 years out from the 2018 games, he's handed his first opportunity to experience it. Athletes from around the world, he's able to test out the innovative and extremely progressive course, quickly realizing that its stunning design gives him a huge amount of options that will ultimately influence his final run in 2018.
on s'est demandé est-ce que...
Every single time this guy steps up, I get goosebumps. He is so technical, so skilled, and so in control of everything out there. I really do feel... Switch to cork, 540. Rodeo with a clean grab. Cork with a clean grab. Rodeo with a grab. Oh, that was a nasty fall. Not sure you can come back from that. Nailing that nose slide. Front flip with a nicely locked in grab. A head spinning quad rodeo with a grab. Decent air with that jump. Time to follow up with a meaty trick. Ah, just couldn't quite put the landing gear down on that one.
Woo! I just ripped that ride apart.
Really spicing up that rodeo with a clean grab right at the end. A ridiculous double backflip with a grab. And into the nose press. Front flip with a clean grab. Nailing the tail slide like it was nothing. Nicely jazzing up that cork with a grab at the end. Cork with a grab. Good air coming off that jump. Let's hope we see a stylish trick. A big, big double backflip with a grab. Rodeo with a tight grab. It's a shame when you see someone bottom out like that, but he just wasn't ready to compete at this level. I do hope he picks himself up. See him again soon.
Opportunities for a break in his intense schedule, although few and far between, are the ones he'll cherish long after they've ended. With the test event in Korea under his belt, and another coming up in just 1 week's time, the next 24 hours are a chance to relax and take in the stunning Japanese backcountry at his own pace. With last year's test event a success.
We're in the land of the rising sun and about to catch our first glimpse of the biggest sensation of last season. For me, we are looking at one of the most versatile athletes in years. And I'm curious to see what he can do after last year's test event in South Korea. Rodeo with a clean grab. Dropping a grab into that front flip, just what the judges want. Oh man, have you ever seen a run like this? We are watching history unfold here. Double cork with a stylish grab. stopping that nose slide. A front flip, really clean, but the next one will need to be bigger to impress the judges.
I'm fine!
A sick triple front flip with a very tight grab. Going for the grab during that 900.
Ha ha! Awesome ride!
An impressive run that firmly cements his status as the slopestyle favorite for the 2018 Games. And it doesn't look like the summer hiatus has had any sort of adverse effect on his abilities. Nailing the tail slide like it was nothing. 360 with a smooth grab. Front flip with a grab. A beautifully executed cork. Stomping that 50-50. And into a nose slide. Rodeo with a grab. Straight into the nose press. Locking in the grab during the front flip. Locking in the grab tightly during the back flip. Front flip with a nicely locked in grab. Nice, great height coming out of that jump, so let's see it used right. A dizzying triple cork with a grab. 1440, perfect grab. This is superhuman stuff right here.
Oh, crap.
Oh, taking some huge risk here with those massive tricks, but every one of them is paying off big dividends. Latching on hard with the grab, coming out of that huge 900. If you want to see what a true champion looks like, then focus all of your attention on this guy. And straight into the nose press, landing that 360 with a tight grab. Into the rodeo and hitting the landing with zero problems. Cork 720, nice. Easily stomping that rodeo. Cork with a grab at the end there. Rodeo with a tight grab. So focused, so in the zone, this is simply unbelievable to watch. Burning through tricks like it was nothing. This run is a masterclass. Unbelievable, he's delivered yet again. These runs he pulls out at every one of these events are just so incredible to watch. He just comes out firing and schools every other rider out there with those huge performances. Connecting the grab to the 1080. Decent air with that jump. Time to follow up with a meaty trick. Cork with a clean grab. Plenty of air coming out of that jump, but will it be used? Oh, that's a tight grab on that double cork. Nicely locking in the grab to that big double front flip. A perfect grab and a massive 1260. Nicely jazzing up that cork with a grab at the end. Really spicing up that rodeo with a clean grab right at the end. Taking some huge risk here with those massive tricks, but every one of them is paying off big dividends. Wow, a crazy triple cork with a grab. That would have been so smooth if that landing hadn't been botched. Good height off the jump. Let's see it put to good use. Perfect grab during that head-spinning double rodeo. dropping the grab into that 1260. Nice clean grab during that 900. Double rodeo with a grab. Laying down a clean 50-50, dropping a grab into that front flip, just what the judges want. Cork with, oh, just going down at the end. With a tight grab. And into the grab on the double front flip. Killer triple rodeo with a grab. Nice, great height coming out of that jump, so let's see it used right. Really, again? We're seeing a lot of repetition during this run, which is not good at this level. Coming off that jump. Let's hope we see a stylish trick. Oh man, have you ever seen a run like this? We are watching, wasn't expecting that. I really thought that one was landing.
Woo! What a ride. What a rush! Yeah!
With his status as a favorite for slope style in South Korea's South Korea looming large. In halfpipe, judges pay close attention to a number of factors, including amplitude. The greater the height during a jump, the more points awarded. So here, training is dedicated to gaining the highest amplitude during jumps, while also maintaining speed and fluidity. Style and variety are equally important during a run. So time in the halfpipe training camp is maximized, executing a specific set of tricks that will be used in runs during future events and ultimately the 2018 Olympic Winter Games. Here, the goal is to piece together a full run in the halfpipe, chaining trick after trick. He repeats this process countless times until he finally settles on something he will perfect for the Olympic Winter Games in South Korea in 85 days.
Aujourd'hui, les runs, ils sont...
For some coaches, what separates real champions from the other athletes is their mindset. In competition, athletes must adapt their runs according to what's come before them, which means strong mental skill are key to winning. But some use tactics such as positive visualization of the runs they prepare as a means of enhancing their mental state. This is why he uses this method to prepare. After a long summer of intensive training.
By now, everyone's aware of the fact we are officially in Olympic season. And let me tell you something, every athlete out here is looking to win and win big, especially this guy right here. All eyes on him after that sensational performance last season. So he's going to be looking to deliver big here today. Oh man, have you ever seen a run like this? We are watching history unfold here. Oh, so unlucky. I think we're going to see some big points deducted for that fall. Such a focused and assured run, total control. The summer break clearly hasn't had any sort of effect on his ability to bring it. This guy just continues to impress me every single time he drops into the half pipe. Let's see if he can match his very strong performance from that first event. Clean grab during that buttery smooth double cork. Very nice. Rodeo with a grab at the end. Work with a clean grab. A perfect grab during that 1080.
What a ride, dude.
Whoa. You can really tell he's worked so hard to get to this level, and every time he drops into the half pipe, he pushes it to the limit. And that's exactly what he's just done here. He has set the bar at every event whenever he straps on the board, and he always looks so calm and collected during those big runs. Right now, everything is firing for him. So let's see if he can do the same again here today. A clean grab during that massive double cork. Locking down the grab into the 720. Dropping a grab into that double front flip, silky smooth. Oh, taking some huge risk here with those massive tricks, but every one of them is paying off big dividends.
With the half pipe tour in the Alps at an end, he emerges as a favorite for the 2018 Olympic Winter Games. And for many of the athletes, one of the most rewarding points of the preparation process is the arrival of the official gear that will be worn during the 2018 Olympic Winter Games. Like him, they take great pride in this particular moment, but it's also essential that they train in it to ensure it fits comfortably and doesn't compromise movement. And with the national team selection still undecided, it gives them additional motivation to impress the coaches and make the final cut. Despite trying to remain focused on South Korea,
je pense qu'on devient le meilleur en étant pas.
Knowing the quadruple is now essential to winning and turning the dream into a reality, he realizes he must push harder than ever before in these, the final days of preparation for the games. For him, the quadruple is his Everest, and he must conquer it. Days of intensive training, he is now ready to show the world he has mastered the quadruple. To unveil the trick, he travels to the Tateyama Kurobe Alpine Route in Toyama, Japan. The sporting world watched in awe as he... Four competitors chosen for each freestyle discipline. Coaches continue to evaluate athletes during the final series of events. He's now under incredible pressure to keep performance levels at a high to make the cut. And in some cases, team selection won't be revealed until events wrap up. For many, including him, this is one of the most stressful moments on their journey to South Korea.
That was an insane jump. Let's see if the big air is put to good use. Oh, what a shame. Couldn't get the landing gear down. The judges are gonna dock some big points for that. Hopefully that won't hurt the sport too much again. Burning through tricks like it was nothing. This run is a masterclass. Couldn't quite nail the landing on that big quad rodeo. Rodeo! Listen to the crowds go wild after that! Oh man, have you ever seen a run like this? We are watching history unfold here. Wasn't expecting that. I really thought that one was landing. Latching on hard with the grab. Not a lot of time to pull a trick out of the bag with that weak jump. Look at the hold time on that grab coming out of the 720. Really missed a chance to grab big air and go for something special. The judges want to see grabs during the tricks, and that's exactly what they got at the end of that backflip. Oh, just couldn't hold that cork together at the very end. Breaking out the grab and holding on at the end of that smooth 540.
That was awesome!
plenty of air coming out of that jump, but will it be used? Connecting the grab to that 900. Rodeo with a tight grab. Stomping that 50-50. Rodeo and nailing that landing with absolute authority. Cork with a grab. Cork with a tight grab. Nicely jazzing up that cork with a grab at the end. Cork with a clean grab. Sweet grab during that smooth double rodeo. Nice. Very nice. Backflip with a perfect grab, holding the grab perfectly during that big... Oh! Now that I was not expecting at all. Talk about bad luck. Oh, just going down again. Going small with that jump. Not much time to whip. So unlucky. Hopefully that won't hurt the score too much in the end. Not a lot of time to pull a trick out of the bag with that weak jump. Really spicing up that rodeo with a clean grab right at the end. Nailing the tail slide like it was nothing. Front flip with a grab. Rodeo 540. Rodeo with a grab at the end. And into the 540 with style. Front flip and stomping that landing at the end. Locking in the grab during the front flip. Rodeo with a clean grab. Piecing the run together with a very clean, very smooth 360. Yee-haw! Grab on that double cork. And into the grab on that 12. Double, oh! We felt that one all the way up here in the booth, and I'm sure the judges did too.
After thousands of hours of prep.
Dans la carrière d'un... Nous, le stress des qualifs.
Prior to the competition starting, athletes are handed the opportunity to scout the much talked about slopestyle course in Phoenix Snow Park. It's also a chance for them to examine the features up close and personal and become immersed in the course. This key moment in time allows them to visualize their final planned runs more clearly.
The hot favorite, everyone's betting large on taking home those three gold medals. I'm very curious to see what he does here because this park is incredible and it presents some very exciting opportunities. Backflip with a tight grab. with a tight grab. Locking the grab into that 540. Really spicing up that rodeo with a clean grab right at the end. Perfect grab during that head-spinning double rodeo. Look at that! Have you ever seen a run like this before? Amazing! Quark with a grab at the end there. Absolutely stomp that run, and
with the spotlight now on the halfpipe finals, and when it looked like things were slotting into place, disaster struck, and struck hard. Adverse weather conditions seriously affected the state of the halfpipe, and now the big set of tricks he had trained so hard for over the years had to be scrapped in favor of improvisation.
Sean, I'll let you know we have saved the best for last here today. He killed it all season and absolutely stomped it at the slopestyle qualifiers. But given that crazy weather we had here last night and the impact it's had on the halfpipe and the athletes' runs, I want to see what he can do. Perfect grab during that huge triple rodeo. That was a very assured run for him. He should be happy with it. Still haven't seen someone whip out that big quadruple from their bag of tricks. But this is the qualification stage, and I'm wondering if he'd really risk trying a trick like that and possibly hitting the deck. Burning up the powder with a quad front flip and a very clean grab. Maybe we'll see something special at the back, stomping the triple rodeo and the grab.
Worse.
Whoa! That took some serious nerve. So many... at the men's slopestyle finals, and up next is the man we have all been talking about. He's had an incredible season, and if anyone can take home the three golds, it's gonna be this guy. This is a huge moment for him and for winter sports, so strap in and get ready. Burning through tricks like it was nothing, this run is a masterclass. Rodeo 540, laying down a clean 50-50. Nicely into the 540. Rodeo with a tight grab. Oh man, have you ever seen a run like this? We are watching history unfold here. Quadruple rodeo with a sick grab. Miles of style, triple rodeo with a vice-like grab. He has snatched that gold medal here at the men's slopestyle finals. The dream of his is... We're here at the men's finals of the legendary halfpipe, and the atmosphere is electric as the crowds wait for this guy to drop in and try to take home a second goal. Honestly, I can't even begin to imagine the pressure he's feeling after that incredible win at the slopes. A jaw-dropping triple rodeo with a grab. Going for the grab during that dizzying 1260, stomped it. Oh, taking some huge risk here with those massive tricks, but every one of them is paying off big dividends. He's done it. He has taken the top spot and made history in...
With the pressure already immense after taking home gold.
There's always someone ready.
And here we are at the last freestyle event. And I'd be lying if I told you I wasn't hanging on to the edge of my seat. Our final rider of the day is just one run away from making history. And with that big quad being pulled earlier in the competition, he's gonna have to whip out something special in his bag of tricks if he wants to win the judges over. So focused, so in the zone, this is simply unbelievable to watch. Burning through tricks like it was nothing. This run is a masterclass. Good use. Locked on grab on that double rodeo. Well, you really gotta drop the grabs into your runs out there, and that's what we're seeing here. Perfect grab during that huge triple rodeo. On the big triple front flip. Unbelievable. Look at the height coming off that killer triple rodeo with a grab.
What a ride, dude.
Oh, my.
Winning an Olympic medal event
after an incredible 820. 820-